Hey, what's going on? It's Rich DeSisto. Welcome to the basement, or the bunker. This is where I've been spending a lot of my time as we self-isolate with all my friends, John, Paul, George, and Ringo, a bunch of Jimmies, Getty, Robert, even Frank, Dean, and Ella. It's National Record Store Day, too. Unfortunately, we can't take part. They originally moved the date to June 20th, but I don't think that date's going to stand either. But in the meantime, I thought maybe I'd share some of the records and songs that I've been getting me through the last couple of weeks with my album collection. Kind of go A to Z with AC/DC leading us off as we hear Hell's Bells in the background. Let's go back to their third album, though, that was released in 1976. I want to bring that album up first because it's Record Store Day. One of my favorite pastimes is going to record bins at record stores and just spending hours and hours thumbing through, seeing what I can find. And I came across this one at a consignment store in New York. This is the Australian import of Dirty Deeds. Look at the artwork on that compared to the original. Much different. So is the song list and selection on the back. And here's what the original is. Yeah, this album was released in 76 in Australia and Europe, but we didn't get it here in the States until a year after Bon Scott died, in March of 1981. But the album that we're listening to right now, Back in Black, is celebrating its 40th anniversary this year. In fact, July will be 40 years. A funny story on how this album became what we know it as, with Brian Johnson as the new lead singer. Around this time in 1980, they were in the Bahamas recording the album, and Brian has told the story many times about how he was contacted by the rest of the band to come and audition. So while we listen to a little more Hell's Bells, here's Brian to tell that story.
There was this lady on the phone with a heavy German Russian kind of Eastern accent, and she said, I remember it was in the afternoon, it was 2 in the afternoon, she was making the phone round. I went, hello, and she went, you are Brian Johnson? I said, who's asking? She went, they are needing you to come down and sync with the band. I said, what band? She was like, this I cannot tell you. And I said, well, I'm not coming down to London to sing with a band, and I don't know who it is. I said, you've got to tell us, give us a clue. And she said, okay, I will give you the initials. This is the AC and DC. And I went, you mean AC/DC? And she went, Christ, I have said too much. And I just went, oh, wow. I said, when should I come down? That's still my favorite story.